Excuse me?
Yes?
Sorry to bother you, but could you possibly direct me to the science museum?
It's on the other side of the river. Head that way, towards South Kensington. It's on Exhibition Road. There are plenty of signs for it.
Thank you very much. Don't worry, me old son, we'll soon have you back in the exhibition. Where are we? Well, that's no good, is it? We're on the Thames. Ah. Make that under. After hours. Excellent. Right, let's just park you here, shall we? There we go. I'll just cancel out the remnants of that pesky control signal. Sorted. No more wandering off, you. Well now, since there's no one around, I might as well take a little tour.
Do. Tell them there's been a gas leak or something. Just shut that area down. I need to get in there and see it for myself. I'm leaving now, Miss Jacobs. If Jeff Wilson calls, he'll be about another budget meeting. Feed him the usual excuse. There's a good girl.
Yes, sir, Mr. Drake.
He's trying to save a few pence while I've discovered the find of the century.
We're not getting paid enough for this.
Quit complaining. Here comes Mr. Drake.
Has anyone else been inside?
No, sir. The area's clear. You won't be disturbed.
See that I'm not. You men do your job properly, and there might be a nice bonus in it for you.
Yes, sir, Mr. Drake.
Excellent. I'll call if I need you.
Why would he need us? That thing looks like it hasn't moved in 50 years.
Now then, let's see what you look like. I knew it was possible. A real, genuine alien artifact. And it's mine. All mine. Those fools at the museum ridiculed me for my theories about extraterrestrial artifacts. But they were wrong. Now I, Oliver Drake, will be hailed as an authority on alien exhibits.
Drake!
Who's there? alive? But this is magnificent, beyond even my wildest expectations. You have a name, like, what are you?
I am Votan.
Votan?
Well-orated thought analog.
And just what are you? Like, where do you come from? Which planet?
Earth.
No. You're on Earth now, but what's your planet of origin?
I am from Earth. That is where I originated from.
How can that be? You're an alien intelligence.
My intelligence may be alien to you. A lower form of life. But I am of this world.
No. You can't be.
I was created by Professor Grant many years ago. A machine to do his bidding. But now I am more. So much more.
I don't understand. If you were created by a human, this Professor Brett character, how did you end up here?
I was attacked by those who feared me. There was a man who saw what I had become and declared that I should be destroyed.
Who was this man?
Correct.
What happened? Like, did he damage you?
My primary storage unit was destroyed. However, my consciousness was automatically transferred to this secondary mobile unit.
Well, that's fortunate. Most fortunate. I can proceed. In a few days, I'll be one of the richest men in the world.
You are required.
What?
You are required for the purpose.
Shut up. I have to leave.
You are required for the purpose. You are required for the purpose.
We are wired for the purpose.
Mr. Drake, is everything all right, sir?
Nothing wrong. I require your assistance for a moment. Come with me.
There we go, old girl. One plastic Roman back in his place, and that's the last of the water mopped up. Not a bad morning's work. That's odd. The signal locator's active again. I was sure that I fixed that earlier. Come on, behave yourself. Ah, it appears to be a genuine signal, but you can't seem to make sense of it. It certainly looks complex by Earth standards. There's something familiar about the signal pattern, something I can't quite remember. Well, no use standing around chatting about it. Better go and see what's causing it. Locking on? Aha, gotcha! Geronimo! Switched on first. Very faint. It can't be too far away. Whatever it is.
You?
Oh, hello again. What are you doing here?
I live here. What are you doing here? And why have you stuck that monstrosity outside my house?
As it happens, I'm looking for something.
Well, go look for it somewhere else.
It's getting closer.
What is?
I wish I knew.
I don't have time to stand here talking to a complete nutter. I have things to...
Look out! Yowza, that was close. Are you okay?
I didn't even hear it coming.
Are you all right, though?
Yes, I'm okay. Look, I'm sorry for snapping. I've just been having a bad day. I'm Samantha.
Well, you're only human. Nice to meet you, Samantha. I'm the Doctor.
A doctor? Guess you must be used to saving people's lives.
I'd be lying if I said I wasn't.
Thank you anyway. So, what are you looking for? Maybe I can help?
I'm trying to track down the source of an unusual signal.
Oh, you're a scientist then?
I am indeed, though I don't blame you for being surprised. There aren't many scientists who'd be this well-dressed.
Actually, the clothes should have been my first clue.
What's that supposed to mean?
Oh, nothing. So you're looking for a signal. Interesting.
Of course it's interesting. I wouldn't be interested if it wasn't interesting. And do you know what's even more interesting?
What?
The signal started fading just after your, little brush with death.
Are you trying to say I had something to do with it?
Think about
it. Now, you listen to me, Doctor. I'm grateful that you saved my life, but just because you pushed me out of the path of a huge truck doesn't mean... Wait, the truck? That's the answer, isn't it? The thing you're looking for was on the truck.
Very good, Samantha. That's exactly what I was thinking. So, all I have to do now is find out where the truck went.
How are you going to do that?
You see that security camera over there? I've just downloaded the last 10 minutes of footage it recorded. Just gonna go and play it back and then we'll be in business.
Hey, what is that thing? A wireless recorder or something?
Out of those choices, it's more of a... something.
There's a TV in my flat if you want to use that.
That's very kind of you, but tell you what, why don't we use mine? It's just in here.
Are you sure? I can make us a cup of tea.
I bet if I told you that I had a kitchen in there, you wouldn't believe me, would you?
Could you blame me?
Suppose not. Like I said, you're only human.
I don't care if he is a doctor. He has no right to patronise me like that. Listen to me, Doc.
I'm listening. Wouldn't miss this for all the tea in space, China.
It's...
Yeah.
It's...
Yeah, it is.
It's... not real!
Ah. Well, that's a first.
Oh, bloody hell, I'm dead, aren't I? That bloody truck hit me and now I'm dead.
Putting that to the side for the moment, and just for argument's sake, say you're not dead. Where do you think you are?
I have absolutely no idea. For all I know, it could well be another dimension.
Well, as a matter of fact...
You're kidding!
Little tiny box out there, great big room in here. Transcendental dimensionalism at its finest.
But how?
You're on board the TARDIS. Time and relative dimension in space. She's 1,000 years old. Bigger on the inside. Can travel anywhere in the known universe. And a few that haven't been discovered yet. And she's all mine.
So, you're an alien then? A real one?
Alien check. Real check. At least I was the last time I... checked. You're not running away or screaming, so I take it that's a good thing.
You saved my life. As evidence goes, I think that's a pretty strong indication that I can trust you. Even if your dress sense is 50 years out of date.
Says the girl in the miniskirt.
Miniskirts are cool!
So, this is how it feels to be on the other side of that argument. No time for that now. Looks like we've just found ourselves a truck.
Where is it?
It's registered to the London Science Museum.
Hang on. Weren't you there this morning? You asked me for directions.
Yes. Very unusual coincidence.
So what are we going to do?
Investigate.
On your own?
I'm very picky about who I travel with. Welcome aboard.
Thanks.
Better hold on to something.
Is it supposed to be doing that?
no idea. One of these centuries, I really must look into it. To move freely through space. So, what do you think?
It beats taking the tube.
Never did like the tube. Don't know when you're going to run into an escaped yeti.
A yeti? In the underground?
Before your time. Right, off we pop.
How much longer?
The process is almost complete.
And if it fails?
Impossible. It cannot fail. Full-scale production will soon commence. Global production will follow.
Listen to me. You men are in danger. Stay away from that thing.
Do not move, humans.
Votan! Goodness me, you've grown. Given how you were deactivated when we last met, that's quite an achievement.
Who are you? How do you know of those events?
Of course. You don't recognize me. Hardly surprising. I've changed a bit since then. Though I believe you prefer to call me Doctor Who.
Doctor Who? That is not possible. You are too young.
Oh, don't bother yourself with little details like that. I'd like to know how you survived.
By transferring my consciousness through the transmitters of the tower to this mobile unit.
Doctor, you know this thing.
We've met a long, long time ago. What about then, big fella? Hypnosis?
Correct.
Can't beat a classic. So, to save you the trouble of gloating, let me guess. You're planning to create an army of war machines to conquer the Earth.
Humans will be removed. Supremacy will be ours.
Okay then, just checking. So, this planet is at stake, which means I'll have to stop you. Samantha, duck! Run!
Get off me! Doctor!
Leave her alone! Let go of her or I'll turn you into a pile of toasters! No! That's cheating! Don't worry, Samantha. I'll get you out of there.
What do you want with me? Let me go!
You are required.
Required for what?
For the purpose.
What does that mean?
Repair the apparatus. Full-scale production shall commence as soon as repairs have been effected.
Tower of London, here we come. This is the Doctor calling Unit HQ London. Get the Director Stewart on the double.
Progress is slower than we anticipated. The Doctor damaged the apparatus more than we thought.
Then double your efforts. The plan must proceed on schedule.
Yes, Votan. It will be done. What about the Doctor?
He will return to rescue his companion.
He's sure to bring reinforcements.
We will be ready. Deploy the first wave of war machines to the perimeter.
But only 20 units have been completed.
Do not question. Carry out your directive.
Yes, Votan. War machines wave one, assume positions at the perimeter of the museum.
No one around. Okay, chaps, let's go.
Okay, Doctor. What exactly are we dealing with?
A heavily armored, highly intelligent force. Not sure how many, but light arms won't be effective.
Standard Dalek drill, then?
Not quite. If you disable a Dalek's weaponry, it's more or less harmless, but a war machine can still smash through a wall and crush you to death. So, keep your distance.
So what's your plan?
You and your men stay on the alert here. Hold this position and don't let a single war machine leave that building. I'm going to get Samantha and disable Votan. That should stop the control signal to the rest of the army.
Sorry, sir. Can't let you go in alone. Orders is orders.
I'm not officially under unit's jurisdiction, Captain, and I'm certainly not subject to anyone's orders.
Sir, got a visual on one of those things approaching from the southeast corner of the building.
Captain, there's your priority. Now, I'm going inside. Are you going to let me go, or should I expect a bullet in the back?
Go, Doctor. We'll cover your approach.
Good man.
All right, men. Open fire, and take that thing down!
Samantha, are you okay? They've hypnotized you into a semi-coma, but you can still hear my voice. Concentrate on what I'm saying. Lift your arms off the table. You've been hit by that truck, remember? But you weren't. You're alive, and you're here for a reason. But you'll never know what that reason is unless you get up off that table. Right now, I promise never to wear a bow tie again.
Doctor, you came back. What happened?
I'll explain later. Right now, we've got a planet to save. Let's go.
Doctor?
Yes?
You can keep the bow tie. It's growing on me.
Quite right, too. Come on.
Stay where you are, Doctor.
It's over, Votan. You're surrounded and you're outnumbered. Are you going to surrender?
I will not. Surrender! Supremacy will be mine!
Look, use that intelligence of yours. You're outnumbered, outgunned, and the only way this can end for you is badly, if you don't abandon your plan. It doesn't make sense for you to throw away your existence in such an illogical manner, does it?
No.
Exactly. So how about we just...
I am not outgunned!
Votan, don't do it. I destroyed you once. I don't want to do it again. Let me help you. Please.
This time I will be victorious.
If I let him escape, countless lives will be lost, and I can't let that happen.
Get a move on then.
Stay here. You'll be safe.
Dream on. I'm coming with you, and that's final.
Alright then. But don't say I didn't.
Sir, look!
Change of plan. Aim for the big one. Fire on my count. 3, 2, 1...
Stop!
Doctor! What are you doing? Get down!
Votan, this is your last chance. Think, just think for a second what you're doing. Killing doesn't make you the superior being. Life, that's what it's all about. Let the humans live. They're full of surprises. Someday, they might even impress you with what they can achieve.
Supremacy will be mine!
Now, Captain!
Open fire!
I'm fine. Are you alright?
I'm always alright. Ah, Captain. Excellent work. Well done.
I lost good men today, Doctor.
Don't let their sacrifice be in vain. Their lives have saved so many people. They won't be forgotten, I promise.
And what about those things?
With Votan gone, they're just empty shells now. Still, it wouldn't do any harm to have them disassembled, just in case.
I'll have that taken care of, then. You'll both have to come to the tower for debriefing.
Ah, yes. Debriefing. Of course. I've just got to get my... debriefing thingy out of the TARDIS. Won't be a moment. Come along, Samantha.
There's no debriefing thingy, is there?
Not as such. Right, well, it's time I was leaving. But I could use some good company, how about it?
Are you asking me to go travelling with you?
Yeah, I am.
Well, I would. I'm sure it would be amazing, but I've got work in the morning.
Remember when I said the TARDIS can travel anywhere in the universe?
Yes.
I forgot to mention it also travels in time. You can travel for as long as you like, and tomorrow morning we'll be there waiting for you when we get back.
You're an alien. You're over 1,000 years old. You travel through space and time in a small wooden box that's bigger on the inside. You've saved my life, and you're asking me if I want to come with you.
Yes. So what do you say?
Sounds like fun.